गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट ऑटोमोबाइल एरोडायनेमिक बॉडी शेप। लेट अस सी। एज वी नो दैट मोशन ऑफ द व्हीकल टेक प्लेस थ्रू ए लार्ज मास ऑफ आइदर स्टेशनरी एयर और एयर इन मोशन, द एयर exerts force on the auto vehicle. The study of these forces generated by the motion of air is called aerodynamic. So that means that the force exerted by the motion of the air to the vehicle is called aerodynamic. Classification on the basis of flow environment, on the basis of flow environment, it is classified external aerodynamic, internal aerodynamic. On the basis of flow behavior, it is further classified into three types. One is subsonic, second one is the sonic, and third is the supersonic. The field of application of aerodynamic engineering are aerospace engineering, in aerospace designing, design of automobiles. Third one is the prediction of forces and moment in ships and sail. And the fourth one is the in the design of bridge and building for calculation wind load. That means the study of aerodynamic is important in today's life. Now here shows the arbitrary shape of a body which will experience a large resistance . The forces which are going to act are lift force, which is going to move the body in upward direction, vertical upward direction. And the second one is the drag force, which opposes the motion of the body, this one. And third one is the whole weight of the body, vehicle. And third one, fourth one is the thrust. The thrust is the power which is supplied by the engine for the purpose of motion. It is clear in the diagram also. The definition terminology of aerodynamic airfoil body, number one is the lift. It is the sum of all the vertical forces which is acting normally on the body. It is caused by the Bernoulli's effect. Its result, body to rise by creating pressure difference. That means the lift is the vertical force which tries to lift the body. And drag, it is the sum of all the external force in the direction of fluid flow. So it acts opposite to the direction of the body. It is the force which opposes the forward motion of the body through the fluid. That means the drag is the force which opposes the motion, and it's act in the direction opposite to the direction of motion. And weight, it is the sum of all the weight of the vehicle. It acts vertically downward. And the thrust, it is the force which moves the vehicle through the fluid. This force is basically provided by the engine in automobile vehicles. Next, we are going to see the advantage of aerodynamic in car or vehicle. Some are here shown. Aerodynamic help us to increase the efficiency of a vehicle. That means it decreases the fuel consumption. Second one, it increases the speed of the vehicle also. And the third one, it's provide good appearance as well as stylish appearance to the vehicle. And the fourth one is the it's provide stability to the vehicle also. And the next one advantage is the it reduces the noise level of the car also vehicle. Next we are going to see here shows the history behind the evolution of aerodynamics and its important in today's life. In early time in 1920, car design model was designed in which not more attention was paid toward the considering aerodynamic factor, but with the evolution of that time, there was a high demand for the improvement in the design of car model. So we are interested in considering aerodynamic factor also. Now the car which are generally manufactured by the manufacturer are designed by considering the aerodynamic factor also. So today's car is much more efficient and less fuel consumption and provide greater efficiency also, and it also provide greater speed. And third, and then in next slide here, the study of aerodynamic in cars, as we have generally seen in the previous slide, that the forces which are generally acting here over the airfoil are lift force and the drag force. These are the mainly two forces, yeah, major forces which are acting on the body of the vehicle. Let us see. Drag force, it is the force, from the definition it is clear, it is the force which opposes the motion of a vehicle. Its mathematical formula for calculation is F is equal to half CD AB square, where C is the coefficient of drag, D is the density of the air, A is the frontal area, and V is the velocity of the object. From the mathematical formula, it is clear that drag force is directly proportional to the area of the vehicle, and it's also directly proportional to the coefficient drag. In this figure, it is clear that the drag force of a different shape body is having different coefficient of drag. From the experimental, it has been proved that for a spherical body, the coefficient of drag is 0.47. For the half sphere, it is 0.42. For the cone surface, it is 0.5. This all here. From the data, it is clear that the streamline body is having minimum coefficient of drag, that is 0.04. So basically all the vehicle which are generally designed having minimum coefficient of drag in order to have least drag force. So it is designed in the shape of streamline body. From this slide, it is clear that the while motion of a vehicle in the forward direction, how the air goes and how it affects the motion. This shows that during the motion of air over the automobile vehicle, a vacuum is created. So it should be provided a proper shape so that not more vacuum is created, otherwise it will create lot of problem. So from the diagram it is clear that here it shows that the different shape having different rear vacuum creation during the motion. It is clear that this much is created while we are using a square flat plate, and this is the spherical. And from it is clear that the airfoil shape is having the least rear vacuum creation. So this is having a least problem while during the motion. Now next we are going to the major forces which are acting on a vehicle is the lift forces. This is the basically the vertical forces which is acting on a vehicle which tries to lift in the vertical direction. This is basically created due to the difference in the pressure in the lower and in the upward side. And its mathematical formula is half CL dV square A, where CL is the coefficient of lift and D is the density of the air. V square is the velocity of the air, D is the density, and A is the area, frontal area. This shows the figure shows that the how the pressure difference is created while the motion. Now the other forces behind these two major forces are acting while during the motion. The rolling forces, this force is basically created due to the side wind forces, and its mathematical formula is half d rho v square a crm into l, where d is the density of the air, v is the velocity, a is the area, crm is the rolling moment factor coefficient, and l is the length of the wheelbase. Its influence is minor on the vehicle. Next, other type of forces which are acting on a vehicle due to air pressure is the pitching. It is the angular oscillation of the vehicle about the horizontal axis is called pitching. This is also created due to the air pressure difference. Its mathematical formula is half rho v square into cpm into l, just like a rolling. Next type of other type of forces which are acting is the walling. The angular acceleration of the vehicle about the vertical axis is called walling. This is the it is the vertical movement of the complete vehicle body. So the complete body rises up and down and known as bouncing. Its mathematical formula is half d v rho v square a walling moment coefficient, and l is the wheelbase. It is basically created in the middle portion of the vehicle. Walling factor. Here it is clear that the among all the forces which is responsible for aerodynamic is drag forces and the lift forces. These are the major forces. Beside this, other are also having some effect. Surface friction drag is having 10%, interference is having 15%, and the cooling and ventilation system is having 10%, and rotating wheel is having 1%. Now we are going to see the aerodynamic devices in car which are generally used in order to control the aerodynamic forces. Number one is the wings. This is the wings shown here in the racing bike. the other is spoiler, and the third one is the scoops. Let us see one by one. Wings, probably the most popular form of aerodynamic device. Here shows the wings. The wings work by differentiating the pressure on the top and the bottom surface. As the air molecules are approaching the leading edge of the wings, are forced to travel different distance over and below the wings, which results in the lower pressure area under the wings and allow the higher pressure area above the wings to push down on the wings, and hence the car is stable during the high speed. Here it is shown. Here is the high pressure and here is the low pressure. Due to this, pressure difference is created, and the wing, due to the difference in the pressure, the wings is moving downward, and hence the car is stable during the high speed. Next, we are going to see the spoiler. The spoiler is also other method for controlling the aerodynamic, for providing the aerodynamic stability. This is provided at the back portion of the automobile, a vehicle. They act like a barrier to the airfoil in order to build up high pressure in front of the truck or car. It is mostly used in rear car, which are lighter in rear end, because low pressure creates above the truck, which lifts the rear end of the car, and spoiler are used to create high pressure that pushes down the car and also provide stability at the corner. This is, and the another method is the scoops. The scoops or the positive pressure intake consist of air box which has an opening that permits an adequate volume of air to directly enter. Its main function is to provide high pressure, denser air, and adequate volume of air directly into the engine. This is also one of the factor for controlling aerodynamic balance. These are the some methods which are generally used for reducing aerodynamic drag. Here shows how the deflector is used in truck in order to control the aerodynamic drag in trucks. Another method is the with the help of air flow guide vanes. Here it is basically used in truck, big trucks, or in even in bus also. And the next method is the in aerodynamic in F1 car, in racing cars. These are basically designed in order to lower the drag effect, in order to reduce high fuel, in order to reduce fuel consumption, and to provide higher speed to the vehicle. These are the factor which we have to consider in order to lower the drag effects in racing vehicles. Next, we are going to the method which are generally used for the calculation or evolution of aerodynamic of car. Number one is the wind tunnel, and the second one is the softwares. Wind tunnel is a research tool developed to study the effect of air moving over or round solid object. Air is blown or sucked around a duct equipped with a viewing port and instrument where model or geometrical shape are mounted for study. Wind tunnel testing is a trial and error process. Basically, wind tunnel is a process which is used by the manufacturer for testing the aerodynamic drag. It is a trial process which is used. And the another is the software process is the software. Number of software are developed for the analysis and optimization of aerodynamic in automobile. For design and analysis, the most commonly software are CATIA, CFD software, or etc. Software program make possible to test small piece size parts, which are costly in wind tunnel also. So basically, these are the methods which are generally used before producing any vehicle. It is used by the manufacturer for improving the quality. So, thank you.